hear us come up within 50 feet of us. Let's see if we can get a little closer to him.
Back it up.
You
want
under?
Yeah.
Fish on!
Fish on!
Woohoo! Can you get the harpoon back?
I don't know what I'm hooked on.
The branch.
You got a branch. So I wish you got it that way.
So much for my fishing skills. What's happening here?
He's pulling. And he's pulling rod in with
him. He's what?
He has other ideas of where he's going. And the
buoy. Don't lose the buoy, Dave.
I don't mind the buoy, but he's taking the rod.
You got the rod?
Okay, Dave, get it closer.
I'm pulling the alligator at this point.
Dave, how we doing?
Doing good. So we got our first alligator of the season on the line.
Looks like he's right over here.
He's running.
Right up there, he's right there. Pull up. Slow. Yeah,
he's pulling now. Oh, he's right there.
Whoa, God. Hang on. I got him. This is great. Oh, my God. He's big. He's so big.
And what we have here is a bang stick. And these are very interesting because you really have to be careful with these or you blow your hand off. These are my very big Remington 44 bullets. Take one. The trick to this is to always never put your finger in front of it. So it will make a great show if I blow my finger off. But take the bullet, put it in here very gently, point it away from you at all times. And then you bring this in. Now the safety keeps it from firing your finger off. And there's a black line here that does this. Now, when you do this, you want to make sure that you do it underwater because it can ricochet and off the very hard skull if you miss the alligator. And that's kind of a bad thing if it comes back at you.
All right, so you see the two ridges?
Yeah.
That's right where the backbone, right in between that is where the backbone runs.
Yeah.
You see the skull plate?
Yep.
The black piece?
Yep.
You want to go right behind that, in between those two ridges. Ready?
Yep.
Oh, God.
That was a good shot.
Excellent shot.
This is exactly why you come fishing down in Florida. This is not a panfish. This is not a bass. You want something that's going to pull, that's going to tighten your line out. This is how we go urban fishing. we will see you on the next episode once we get this guy all tied up and we'll lay him out for you. But stay tuned. Can't wait to see you there. Welcome back to Urban Fishing Show. Today I'm at the Alligator Farm, and this is a big old boiler.